The next one, we are going to classify the digital computers. Okay, there are three different types of computers based on the technology: analog computer, digital computer, and hybrid computer. As I said earlier, analog and hybrid we are not going to use. Okay, we are going to use digital computers. So I'm going to classify the digital computers. Again, based on the computing capabilities. Based on the computing capabilities, I am going to classify the digital computers. Okay. So the first one is microcomputer, second one mini computer, then mainframes, then supercomputers. Okay. Then if you see, I can classify in other way. What are the computers I'm using for my individual use? What are the computers I'm going to use for my office purpose? Okay, so this microcomputers, even mini computer also, I can say I'm going to use it for my individual purpose, home purpose. Okay, mini computers, mainframes, supercomputers, they are used for official purpose. So you can think the classification in two different ways. One is based on the computing capabilities. What are the computing capability of microcomputer, mini, mainframe, supercomputer, I'm classifying. Other way of understanding is for individual use, what are the computers, what are the digital computers I'm going to use. For official purpose, what are the digital computers I'm going to use. First one is microcomputers. Okay, so it is also known as the personal computers. Whatever the laptops, mobile phones, PDAs, tablets you are using, all are examples of microcomputers. Okay, this type of digital computer uses a microprocessor. Okay, that means a CPU on a single chip, and these computers works for a small volume of data. Okay, say for example, whatever the laptop you have, so you may be using a laptop to access the online classes, to play some games, to store some movies or something. Okay, family photos, some videos, that is so the volume of data you have, some limited capacity, say for example 200 GB 500 GB, like that. So you have some limited capacity, it will process some limited amount of data. Okay, based on the process, whatever you are using, it will process accordingly. Okay, this microcomputers, they are used as workstations, multimedia, advertising applications. So PDAs are one example. PDAs, tablets. PDA stands for personal digital assistants. Okay, they are the examples of microcomputers. Whatever the desktop computers you have in your home. Okay, that is one example. Again, I said this comes under the computers, digital computers. They are used for individual use. Okay, this is one example. Similarly, for individual use, we can use workstations. Okay, I will say what is a workstation. From my point of view, I'm just telling. Say I have some laptop. It is i5. Okay, laptop. If I run some research work in the MATLAB tool, whatever I have installed in my laptop, it will nearly take 3 to 4 days. Okay, to complete one code. So instead of that, if I use workstation, okay, in laboratory we have some workstation with higher RAM, okay, higher processing capabilities. If you see, I can execute the same MATLAB code within 2 hours or 3 hours. So it is specialized computer. It's mainly used for it is optimized for scientific and graphical applications. This is more powerful than desktop. I can quickly execute my program. Not only this is from my point of view, my application. So based on the individual uses, they will give different examples. So workstations are more powerful. Again, it is used for individual use. Then notebook computers. Okay, this is portable and smaller in size. It has weight from 3 to 8 pounds, and this is the size. Okay, so it's similar as powerful like desktop computers. This is also used for individuals. Okay, then tablet. Most of the students now you have the tablet. Okay, some of the tablets are connected with the pen so that you can annotate. How I am doing? Okay, in the same manner. See, I'm just doing annotation while teaching. Okay, these are tablet computers. Again, it is used for individual purpose. Okay, it is used for individual purpose. Then this PDA, personal digital assistant. Okay. This is also called as handheld computer or palm computer. Mainly it is used for telephone voice calls, to make voice calls, okay, and to store some contacts, okay. But this can be connected to your desktop and it can be synchronized, okay. Mainly it is used for voice based communication. Nowadays, whatever the phones you have, they are smartphones. Okay, it is smartphones are the hybrid between cell phone and PDA. Cell phone, the earlier cell phones, they are mainly used for voice communication. You can send some SMS, you can store some contacts. These are the applications. It can't be used for email transferring, email downloading something, all those things. But with the use of smartphones, you can send emails, you can access web browsers, you can download something, you can upload your YouTube videos. Okay, so many applications are there. So again, it is used for individual use. Smartphones are for individual use. If you see in the year 2007, Apple has introduced iPhone. Okay. So after that, many companies came into the market. They are introducing smartphones, okay, and it is very much successful. Okay, so everyone in our hands we have a computer, okay, digital computer. Then we'll start discussing about what are the computers used for official purpose. One is mini computer. So in the previous case, only one person. It's for individual use. Here, it can support multiple users working simultaneously on the same machine. Okay, these are mainly installed in organizations. Okay, where various departments are interconnected. Okay, and it is used in small business organizations. So you can. See the picture. Okay, there are many mini computers. All the computers are connected. Different departments have different number of computers. All are interconnected basically. Okay, then so this is other name. It is also called as mid-range computers. It has the power. Okay, the power is between mainframe and desktop. Okay, it requires moderate power. Okay, it can handle hundreds of users. That is the benefit. It can handle hundreds of users used in small organizations. You can access the system. You can access through a terminal. You need a system. Then servers. In order to connect, okay, in order to connect all these small terminals, you need servers. When your system is connected to the server, even from the house, you can access the office. Okay, you can access the office information, network servers. Then the next one is mainframe. These computers are larger in size. They are very powerful computers. Okay, and they have very high memory. Okay. So it can process huge database, something like the census data. It can process, okay, census data for all the population kind of thing, age, okay, all those informations. It's a huge amount of data. It will process very quickly. Okay, it is used in big organizations, whatever the banks, industries they use. Okay, that's mainly mainframe computers. It can support hundreds of users simultaneously on the network. Okay, these are the mainframe computers. Okay, as I said earlier, it is larger in size and it has high processing capability. Another one is supercomputers. These are the fastest computers and it is expensive. Okay, so per second, it will execute billions of instructions. Okay, so if you write your code, we are going to see. If you write a lengthy code in our own laptop, it will take much time. Lengthy code means not some 800 lines, some 900 lines. If you write a code for your research work and if you execute, it will take days, okay, to complete the code. Whereas these supercomputers, they can execute billions of instructions per second, in second, okay. So they use multiple processors, parallel systems, okay, so in order to solve huge amount of mathematical calculations. Okay, this is used in applications like weather forecasting. Okay, so we discussed what are the classifications, what are the categories of digital computers, microcomputer, mini computer. Okay, then mainframe computers, supercomputers. Okay, if you see this supercomputer, mainframe computer, and mini computers, they are used for official purpose. Microcomputers are used for individual purpose. Okay,